Alright guys, welcome back. It is now time for episode 4 of this Let's Play series in City Skylines in the city of Los Rico. Last episode, we added in this section, and a bunch of tram lines. Right now, we are taking a look at some of our services. Power, it's pretty good. I added in an extra power plant last episode. It's almost time to add in a water and a sewage plant. Our garbage, not necessarily worried about it yet because we're going to the incinerators and we're going to take care of that. Health, excuse me, healthcare, it's alright. It's not the worst it's ever been. Death care, that's not too bad either. Traffic, I mean, this stretch of road, but it's also got tram lines and stuff on it, so I'm not too worried about it. Pollution, eh. Noise, 29%, so we'll probably add in a bunch of trees around this and this to try and suck up some of that noise pollution. And for those of you who do not know, noise pollution does get sucked up by trees. I built a huge transportation hub and it skyrocketed the noise pollution to like 45% because it just sat in the heart of the city and I surrounded it with trees. And I mean, it took me probably about 45 minutes of tree planting and it dropped it all the way down to like 17%. It was crazy. So we are definitely going to do that. Our fire coverage is pretty good. I have a bunch of fire stations over in our industrial section, so I'm not too worried about it. Crime, 4%. Crime, honestly, in this game has not ever been that bad. Transportation, we have a very strong transportation system, I believe, just for a basic system. We have about 160 people riding the buses per week, which is also bringing in 8 tourists per week. About 450 people riding the trams, with bringing in about 12 tourists per week, and we have 15 citizens taking taxis per week, for a grand total of 616 people per week using transportation, which is roughly, comparing it to our population, doing the math, that's like 9% of our population using transportation. Public transportation, which to me is awesome. It means that less people are using their cars, which should mean traffic is going to be easier to work with. Now, I did say in the end of last episode we would change this over, but I don't really know if it's ready to do that just yet. If anything, you know what I'm thinking, because we do have a high population demand, I'm gonna do something I should have did about 2 episodes ago, and that is, what do we have? Pause the game. There we go. Yes. Awesome. Okay, let's pause the game. Now I get to do what I wanted to do. I'm gonna drop 2 of these in. 3 of these in. And we're gonna dump these. Because I do not want these things anymore. Never liked them. Don't want them now. So let's make sure. If I have to drop an extra one, I will. Awesome. Works. Let's pause for station identification. Now, what I want to do is build bike lanes. 2-lane bike lanes. Like so. Alright. And we are going to add in our very first. Oh, does it not want to? Does it not want to go up right? Can I go under it? Oh, now I have an idea. This is going to be awesome. We're going to build a micro tunnel. Underneath here. And build a nice little neighborhood. Right there. And we're going to make it absolutely 100% about bikes. Come on. You know you want to work for me. Alright. And then we'll just do this. And do this. And I know it's really, really, really stupidly close to the highway, and you're probably thinking that noise pollution is going to cause these people not to move in, and you might very well be right, but it's going to give the city some height, which I now think it is time to start doing. So we're going to turn this to high density. And we're going to put our first stretch of offices right there. Okay. Fill that in. And then any other truly, truly rough areas like that, noise pollution wise, I'm going to turn these into offices. Noise, they kind of act as a barrier. And, They soak up a lot of the noise. They can handle the noise that a lot of these buildings just simply cannot live up with. So I'm just gonna mass fill in a bunch of this stuff and go back to 3-speed. Oh, let's watch. And I know a lot of you are thinking that the sound for this has not been on, and you are right. I usually play with the sound on, but for recording purposes, I want to focus more on like just getting all of my natural vocal tones dialed in before I turn back on the sound for the in-game. So probably episode 5 or 6 or something, I'll probably turn the in-game music on. We can listen to the in-game radio, which I don't know if you guys have played City Skylines, but the in-game radio for this is just, it's just cute. It's, there's no better word to explain it but cute. And I know that's not necessarily the best word to use to describe it, but it's basically the best word to describe it that comes to mind offhand. Alright, trees, lots and lots and lots and lots and lots of trees. All of the trees. We love trees. Alright, guys. Except, we are building a tropical city, so soak this up just a little more. Try to work. Alright, just building a barrier around the roads here. Just because this is going to be higher density, I do want the roads, the noise pollution to get sucked up by the trees. Which these trees will do. If I knew the palm trees did that to the noise pollution, I would definitely... Oh, I can also get rid of these, because we don't need them. Which now means I can do this. Boom. Let's go back to planting some trees. And I'm going to plant trees while it's dark, just so you guys can see this when the sun comes back up. And I think you guys are going to like what this turns into. It may not be done, but for time's sake, I think it'll really, really make its point. I'll make my point when the sun comes back up. And we got the time and the money to spend here, so... Yes, just fill it all in. And mass clicking. I think we are gonna add, depending on how much time we do have, we might do a mass, just a really big expansion, I want to get this noise pollution under control before it does get out of hand, because when it gets out of hand, it gets annoying, because your people get sick, you don't want your people to get sick. And is it almost daytime? Yes, it is. So, let me show you what I'm talking about. So this wasn't necessarily a hotspot for noise, but what it was visually unappeasing. There was nothing really special about this area besides the fact that it was the highway. Okay? Now, you plop some trees down. It looks like a forest. It looks like you're driving through a forest. And that is what I think makes this so visually pleasing. Just hug the highway with some trees, just to spruce it all up. Zoom in, let's fill this all in. And side note here, originally when I was designing the tram network off camera, I was gonna do something with the tram lines so they'd come up to here and then they'd branch out and go underneath the roundabout here, the highway interchange, and then come out on the other side and reconnect back into the road system. But I tried it, I didn't save it, but it basically tanked the entire city's economy and money flow. And it caused a massive, massive, massive traffic jam. And I just was not going to deal with it. So I just save scrubbed and called it quits on that idea. Maybe some of you guys who are a little more experienced or have a lot more playtime with the game might be able to do something like that. I personally cannot. I don't know how to do it. And for those of you who do watch my videos, I have plans to put, like, the custom thumbnails, for title, like a title screen on my videos. My girlfriend is a graphic design intern for a company, and she does marketing and all that, and she goes to school for this stuff. So I'm having her whip up some really awesome designs, to make the channel and all these videos just look a little more professional. Well, not necessarily look, you know, extra special, but I think for quality purposes, if you're gonna do something like that, you should at least make an effort to show people you care about what you're making and putting out for people to see. So, it's about pride for me. I don't want you guys to see something that's kind of cruddy or anything like that, and it can cause me to cause, not cause me necessarily, but cause people not to want to watch this content, I guess that would be a little counterintuitive to what I desire to happen. No, it's still flooding trees in here. I'm trying to just soak up as much of the noise as possible. More noise I can soak up, the better. Because noise pollution is not fun. Alright, gotta switch hands to click because my right hand is completely just crapped out on me. Being naturally left-handed is about playing video games with your right hand, especially a mouse, is just not ever been the most efficient. But I could switch over. Okay, let's do that. Just stockpiling all of our money. Now I'm going to show you guys the difference here with the noise pollution when I'm done. Because it should be better. I think when I showed you guys it was at like 27% or something like that. And if I'm correct, if I've done this right, it should drop our noise pollution down to 20%, maybe? 22%? Just soaking up as much of this as possible. Yep. I like forests. I'm a big sucker for trees. All of my cities are just forested areas. And when I think of a tropical city, I do think of a rainforest. You know, a city like Rio de Janeiro. Pardon me if I have completely just butchered that. I am not a professional speaker at all. But, I think of a city like Rio de Janeiro or, another tropical city, like Mexico City. It just kind of hotter climates. I think of rainforests. I think, lots of vibrant trees, just roadworks, the roads just kind of come out of the woodworks just like this. And if I'm right or wrong, please feel free to comment in the leave a comment down in the comment section. Sorry guys, I just can't speak tonight. And I will do my best to edit this, because I do want to make a tropical city, but I'm going to make it with my own twist. So, ergo, the mass amount of trees. Alright. Suck up some more noise pollution. And I have considered turning off the day-night cycle to build, just because it's kind of hard for me to build at night in this game. I have kind of poor eye vision, so it makes causes me to strain my eyes to see what I'm doing and causes headaches, and that's no bueno. It's no fun at all. So, we're almost done. Just fattening up some of these areas. Prettying up. Okay. Alright, we'll call that good. Now, let's go over to the noise pollution. 20%! What did I say? We shorted it all up. It's almost non-existent over here. And I've definitely dwindled it into here. The offices here have helped cut that down. And I'm gonna put a couple of offices here and here. And here. So any trees that happen to be there might get lost, but that's okay. Okay, now, let's move this way. You know what we're gonna do? We're gonna curve. I think it's time we do that. Okay. Now, I think I'm going to make this a tram line here and here to support the main network, and the rest is going to be two lane of bicycles, just so we can get, again, so just we can get people riding their bikes. I would rather people be riding bikes and not necessarily in the way of anybody where they can get themselves hurt. It's going to be our next little neighborhood. And I haven't done any district drawing yet, and that's just because I'm not ready to do that. What I'm gonna do, I'm gonna do a whole episode design specifically about districting and how I, my process, how I do it, why I do it that way, and hopefully you guys enjoy that. But that will not be for a while. And we are going to do this. This will probably be one of our main downtown-y like areas. So I will do this. Oh, not there. Boom. Yes, let's do this. And boom, blah, 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 blah. Paint, 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 paint. Oh, might be time to upgrade our water. We are probably gonna have to after I'm done though. Alright, death, coverage, put that there, we'll put this here. The road maintenance depot. I want to put that down too. Just so we can get some road maintenance going. Okay, let's take a look. Alright. Let's buy this one. And that one. And that's because we are going to do... That's just Jesus, Mother Mary and Joseph. Oh, okay. Okay, that actually turned out really, really cool. I think this interchange will really support the area. What the heck? Oh, looks like I have to terraform. Oh, wrong button. What did I do? Oh boy. Oh no, what did I do? Okay, no. There we go. I should be able to work with that. Okay, or perhaps not. Okay. Now, here's the tricky part. I have to be able to reconnect these rooms without... I can do this. Which, when I get this tile, I can fix this and straighten it out. But, for the time being... Are we dealing with a slope problem? Is that right? That's a deal? It is. Alright. Alright, alright, alright. You. But what I did want to do was go outward. And possibly make a roundabout. A very, very, very large roundabout. That way, I can support this high number, this high volume of traffic. Well, that's just... Sorry, guys, I should be talking more. I just really, really focused on this. It's kind of frustrating when it doesn't want to work out. Okay. So, we're going to experiment here. So we have another, we have our second highway interchange with a roundabout that has three exits, or one entrance, two exits. So you can come on, go in, you can circle back around and go here and enter the city there, or you can go in and enter that way. You have a straight shot to that. Oh, would you look at that? We are, unfortunately, out of time. Well, time flies. But I do want to see this work. So, I want to see... Oh, there's one car. Yeah, there's a couple of cars using it. Honestly, it just looked really cool. And it looked like a simple enough interchange. Except... That is a very, very, very high volume of traffic using this. There. Wind it out just a little bit. Okay. Alright, guys. Well, I'm sorry. I wish we did more. But at the conclusion of this episode, we built a whole new area. That's probably going to become our downtown, and what I'll do is, I'll wrap it, it'll come this way, and it'll curve again, and it'll come to about right here. So all of this will probably be the main downtown core. We'll have the highway come down and support it, which I think what I'll do is I'll have this highway come down here, and we'll put an interchange right in here. And we'll have these two highways meet. So we have the in-town highway and the other half of the in-town highway kind of meet. And it'll make kind of a U, kind of like a case around this. So this will come down. This will probably go this way and around. Oh, and another milestone. We'll pause. And that will probably be what we do for the next several episodes. So I'm going to sign off. You guys have been great again. Remember to like, share, subscribe, show a friend. And this has been City Skylines, the city of Los Rico. We are at a population of 9,504. And I've been the Field Marshal Desert Fox, guys. Thanks again for coming out and hanging out and spending your day with me. And enjoy yourself. Till next time.